Hello, friends. Welcome to Engineering Today. Believe it or not, this episode, we're only covering SpaceX, and all three updates are really interesting. Let's start with our favorite one, SpaceX Starship update. Then we'll cover Dragon 2 and the lunar contract news. So, on the 13th of January, 2021, SpaceX's latest Starship prototype, serial number 9, or SN9, completed three static fire tests in a single day. SpaceX Starship prototype SN9 ignited its Raptor engines on Wednesday first at 12:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, then at 2:22 p.m. Central Standard Time, and the last one at about 3:37 p.m. Central Standard Time. Just a week before, SpaceX carried out its first static fire test of SN9. Wednesday's test completed the second, third, and fourth static fire tests of SN9. SpaceX carried out these tests from the South Texas facilities near the Gulf Coast village of Boca Chica. All these tests conducted were very short than the first static fire test. After the completion of the first two static fire tests of the day, SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk tweeted, "Today at SpaceX is about practicing Starship engine starts. Ship is held down by massive pins while engines are fired. Two starts completed, about to try a third." There was a gap for nearly 90 minutes, and then the Raptor again roared at about 3:37 p.m. With the completion of three tests, SpaceX has broken its own record. Elon Musk tweeted, "All three static fire tests completed, and no rapid unscheduled disassembly." Chris B., a member of NASA Spaceflight, tweeted about the record made by SpaceX, "Static fire for Starship SN9 again. The first time Starship has conducted same day, back-to-back, triple Raptor static fire tests. During static fires, engines ignite for a short time. The vehicle remains anchored to the ground with help of massive pins. The necessity for testing regarding ignition of Raptor engines on SN9 is to ensure that the engines might not create any problem during high-altitude flight tests. This time, more emphasis was given on static fire tests, as the Starship's first test may have completed prematurely because of any problem with ignition of Raptor engines." In a tweet, Everyday Astronaut appreciated SpaceX. "Awesome milestone. Back-to-back static fires. We've never seen that before. Very impressive." They've also asked about detanking procedure. "And they still haven't detanked. Think they'll go for four?" Musk tweeted in a reply, "Detanking and inspections now. Good progress toward our hop in and go to Mars goal." But later, SpaceX has pushed back the Starship SN9 launch as Elon Musk took to Twitter to confirm two of the rocket's Raptor engines are in need of repairs. SpaceX's Starship prototype is now expected to launch no earlier than January 18th, Monday, although further delays might be possible. On Friday, the 15th of January, Elon Musk took to Twitter to announce two of the Starship's engines need replacement. Musk was asked by one SpaceX fan whether the company was still aiming at a weekend launch. Musk replied, "Two of the engines need slight repairs, so will be switched out." With two of the Starship's engines due to be replaced, chances are the test flight will suffer more delays. Before that, SpaceX will need to complete another round of static fire tests for the new Raptor engines. We're thrilled to see the variety of approaches from these companies. That's all regarding Starship today. Now we'll cover another latest SpaceX achievement as Dragon 2 completed its undocking. The upgraded version of SpaceX Cargo Dragon spacecraft, also known as Dragon 2, completed its first ever autonomous undocking from the International Space Station and then returned to Earth, conducting its first Atlantic splashdown. On January 12th, Tuesday, a historic event took place as SpaceX's Dragon 2 spacecraft successfully undocked from the International Space Station's docking adapter. A live broadcast was shown on NASA TV, where we witnessed the complete undocking process of SpaceX's CRS-21 Cargo Dragon from the Harmony Module's spaceport at 9:05 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. After that, the spacecraft performed a maneuver in orbit and left the station, floating high above the southern Atlantic Ocean, for a splashdown in Florida. After that, NASA astronaut and a member of Expedition 64, Victor Glover, was monitoring the situation. Glover bid farewell to the cargo spacecraft by saying, "Godspeed, Cargo Dragon," and to the recovery team. The event marked the first autonomous undocking of a U.S. commercial cargo spacecraft. SpaceX's previous Cargo Dragon spacecraft was attached and removed by using a robotic hand called Canadarm 2. This upgraded cargo spacecraft is capable of carrying 20% more cargo than its predecessor. At first, the spacecraft's splashdown was set 12 hours after its undocking, but later it was extended to 36 hours. SpaceX's Cargo Dragon 2 spacecraft made its first splashdown on the Atlantic Ocean at about 8:26 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Wednesday, January 13th, 35 hours after its undocking. According to the reports, the CRS-21 Cargo Dragon mission was SpaceX's 21st space station resupply mission and the first to return of a cargo resupply spacecraft off the coast of Florida, SpaceX officials stated on Twitter. According to the information, SpaceX's Cargo Dragon 2 has brought more than 4,400 pounds or 2,000 kilograms of scientific experiments, including other gears, to Earth. I'm excited to finally see science returning here again because we can get these time-sensitive experiments into the lab faster than ever, Kennedy Space Center Utilization Project Manager Jennifer Wahlberg stated. Sending science up to space and then receiving it again on the runway was definitely something in the shuttle days that we really took pride in, and being able to rejoin that process is great. NASA previously said in an update that scientists would begin analyzing the experiments as soon as 4 hours after its splashdown to collect data with minimal loss of microgravity effects. The returning experiments include some detailed reports of cardiovascular cells, important biofilms, and rodent research 23, which involves several live mice who are assisting in an experiment that explains why astronaut eyesight changes in space. Mary Walsh of Kennedy's lead Reed Integration Office Utilization Flight stated, "We are going to have a parade of researchers ready at Kennedy Space Center waiting to receive samples. These scientists will take a quick look to get initial results and then ship it back to their home bases." Wahlberg previously said in a statement, "The benefit of being able to observe the science earlier is the ability to negate any gravitational effects on the research after it's been in space." About 40 minutes before splashdown, SpaceX confirmed Cargo Dragon's stage separation. "Dragon's trunk has separated, deorbit burn complete, and nose cone closed," SpaceX officials stated. Although SpaceX's Cargo Dragon 2 splashdown was not shown live on NASA TV, as per they previously declared, NASA officials confirmed the news of splashdown on Twitter. "SpaceX's Cargo Dragon was successfully splashed down off the coast of Florida. The science and cargo aboard will now be transported to Kennedy Space Center and back into the hands of the researchers," NASA officials of the Kennedy Space Center posted on Twitter. This is only the first month of the new year, and SpaceX already has a number of launches in its sleeves. With a successful return of SpaceX's Cargo Dragon 2 spacecraft, the company is now planning to launch its next ISS cargo resupply mission called CRS-22, which is scheduled in May 2021. But before that, SpaceX has another Crew Dragon launch, known as the Crew 2 mission, scheduled in March of this year. It will take another group of 4 astronauts to the International Space Station. SpaceX's current Crew Dragon capsule from the Crew 1 mission is docked at the space station, which is expected to return to Earth with its 4 crew members in May. Let's move to our last update for today as SpaceX wins another contract, and this time for a lunar lander. Elon Musk's company, SpaceX, is selected as launch provider for the launching of IM-2 lunar lander mission aboard a Falcon 9 rocket in 2022, stated Intuitive Machines. This IM-2 lander will descend on the south polar region of the moon. The lander will convey payloads, which were prepared in October last year by the Commercial Lunar Payload Services Program of National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA. On the 13th of January, 2021, SpaceX gained 2 contracts. First one is the launch of a commercial lunar lander mission supported by NASA, and the second one is launch of private satellite to trace methane emissions. The IM-2 mission will carry out a drilling test known as Polar Resources Ice Mining Experiment 1, or PRIME-1. With the help of Prime 1 tests, the lander will look beneath the ice on the lunar surface for water. Intuitive Machines also said that two other NASA technology payloads will be carried along by the lunar lander. SpaceX is also selected for another lander mission of Intuitive Machines named IM-1, which is scheduled to launch in the middle of 2021. IM-1 and IM-2 lander missions will use Nova-C lander design. Steve Altemus, president and chief executive of Intuitive Machines, said, "Launching Nova-C on a rocket with a proven record of reliability and outstanding value is an assurance to NASA and our commercial payload customers that IM is dedicated to sticking the landing in back-to-back moon missions." SpaceX was also selected by Masten Space Systems, another receiver of NASA's CLPS, to launch their XL-1 lander. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.